Dog, I have so many missing ones.
Guys, we're rolling.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm Evelyn.
And I'm Alicia.
Welcome back to The Pulse.
It's great to know that students have a voice. Recently, students gathered on the field to protest gun violence. Here's some footage from that day.
We're asking for a change because thoughts and prayers are not stopping the deaths of innocent children.
As children, it's hard to realize what we can do to make a difference, but we do have to show Congress and the government that we care as students, and it is affecting us.
Each time we come together, each time we form a united front and create something like this, we make it a lot harder for them to continue to ignore us. And I think in the end, that's what's going to change the world.
Congratulations to Trenton Wagner Adson from Third Hour Film and TV for setting a world record average time for a Rubik's Cube scramble. Over an hour, Trenton made 30 attempts before solving the puzzle in 4.67 seconds. I bet I can do that right now. Oh, maybe not.
Panthers and Eagles are currently in collaboration working on a production of Mamma Mia.
For real?
Yeah, Jaden and Jackson have all the details.
Hi, I'm Jaden. I'm here with Jackson, and he's going to be telling us about a musical that is happening at Flag High with Coconino Panther students.
We are going to be doing Mamma Mia over at Flag High. The dates are April 27th, 28th, and 29th. I hope to see you there.
Thank you, Jackson. I hope all you guys go check it out.
Mr. Proctor asked us all to give a big congrats to freshman Ayana Johns for placing second in the high school category for the Diversity in My Community Art Contest. Congratulations and great job.
Prom is April 29th from 8 p.m. to 11 p.m. at the Orpheum downtown. The theme is going to be Enchanted Masquerade, and the tickets are available for purchase in the bookstore. $30 for one and $60 for two. Prices go up $5 each on April 17th. Only juniors and seniors may purchase prom tickets, and you can only bring a maximum of one guest.
Man, I miss Chris, but sports is always good.
What's up, Panthers from the Sports HQ? I'm Chris.
And I'm Wesley.
And this is Panther Sports.
Welcome back, Panthers, to our final week of regular season and the start of the spring postseason. Let's jump right into track and field.
Track and field had an event last Wednesday for the JV Championship and Open Meet. Kylan C., Rainey Sagani, Wyland Smith, and Talia Yazzie all placed first in their events. Congratulations to all the people who placed first and to JV for finishing their season. Now for girls tennis.
Girls tennis had their final match against Lee Williams last Monday. However, they lost. Good effort from our tennis team this season. Now for softball.
Softball has been doing great these past few weeks. JV went 2-0-1 and varsity went 4-0, scoring a collective 46 runs on their opponents. Good job, softball, and now for baseball.
Varsity baseball is on the edge right now in the playoffs as they could either make it or strike out. Before we get to the varsity baseball team, let's go to the results for our other two teams. The 9-10 team had three games going 0-3 against all three teams, and the JV Stallions had gone 2-1 with their biggest win against Thunderbird 23-5. Now for varsity, they went 1-1 in their last two games with their biggest win against Mojave 8-1. Good job, baseball.
That is it for games this week. Join us next week for the results and start of the postseason. Now back to the main HQ.
And that's a wrap. Later.
Later. I'm gonna go get some more.